Hey golfers, Tony with Reactionary Golf. Happy New Year. Hope you had a great holiday. It is time for myth number three. Do we create lag with this lead arm on the way down? So I want to first give a shout out to my nephew and niece, Nick and Lindsay Luzak, up in Grand Rapids. Got a little Catholic Central sporting lid. Very nice. So I appreciate that for the holiday. We had a great time up in Grand Rapids. A lot of snow and a lot of festivities. So it was great coming back home and seeing my parents up in Bay City. So what I'm gonna do is, on this myth number three, is take a look at what seems very logical, actually. When we get up to the top, we've seen this with a lot of players. Sergio, there's a lot of this lag. Everyone talks about creating this L shape, you know, from the shaft down with your lead arm. The problem with that, where it's not very efficient, even though it looks like it, is because of how the club gets delivered into the ball. We want force into that ball working this way. This is what produces that straight shot. So from down the line, when that club is here into the ball, that's what we're looking for that straight shot. So when we take a look at this position, even though it looks like there's a lot of lag and everything else, it's really kind of a false perspective of really what happens in the golf swing. So this deviation, or this hinging up and down, right, ulnar and radial deviation, appears like it would be great, and I could put a lot of speed. But when we start looking at that, this is a vertical motion. It works very much this way, okay? I'm not gonna hit the ball very far doing this. Great for chopping wood. I get a little outside, I can kind of slap down on it, not going to be very strong and get that glancing blow. So, Matthew Sweeney did some great research in Australia, just kind of validating that the extension and flexion is really what drives that wrist action in the golf swing, not the deviation. So, one thing that's missing, we kind of take a look at, when we get down into here, yeah, there's this angle. But really what we're really looking at is this, and it's a combination of this extension and this adduction of the right arm into the ball that creates the lag. Now, there's a lot of players that will say, okay, you've got to hold that lag and everything like that. And again, that's not very effective, because if I'm thinking, you know, we're a few months away from opening season of baseball, but if I go and check my swing, I've held my lag, but I'm not going to hit any home runs doing that. So I really want to make sure that it's not this pull, hold, off type of motion that's going to create it. We got a lot of modeling research that shows that this motion just isn't what creates club head speed in the golf swing. It may appear to, but you got to think of it from a 3D perspective. It's not how fast the body works biomechanically. So don't worry about trying to pull down with this. This is a very weaker motion. In some of my other videos, we talked about the importance of this, so of the right arm versus the left arm. So what we're looking at is really the better I can kind of throw that club through the ball, the better it's going to be. So we want extension of flexion, not deviation, to produce better golf shots. So hopefully this makes sense. If you want more information, come and join us on Inside the Golf Lab, where we get a lot more detail. And this way you can start off your 2018 golfing season with the best information that's out there, instead of just trying to click on what may be trending in social media. Thanks for watching. We'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.